Taking inspiration from how humans combine implicit with explicit knowledge to tackle unseen tasks, the YOLOR Unified Networks achieved 57.3% AP on the COCO test set, which is better than the recent YOLOV7 E6E model. Hey there, welcome to LearnOpenCV. In this video, we will learn about YOLOR. When training a single model that can solve multiple tasks, that is joint optimization, each task often pulls the weight in the direction suitable to itself, which causes the final overall performance to be worse than training multiple models individually. This is the motivation behind the development of YOLOR, to create a unified network capable of learning general feature representations. YOLOR is the incremental update to the scaled YOLOV4 architecture developed by the same team. It stands for You Only Learn One Representation. Humans can develop experience through regular learning or subconsciously, that is, explicit or implicit knowledge. Using their implicit knowledge, humans can effectively process the same information in multiple ways. For example, we can easily answer various questions using the same data. The same isn't true for neural networks. A trained CNN model can usually only fulfill a single objective and is poorly adaptable to other problems. It only uses the features generated by the network based on the given input. This corresponds to the explicit knowledge, but the abundant implicit knowledge of the network is left unused. The YOLOR models combine explicit and implicit knowledge to generate representations that can be used for multiple tasks simultaneously. YOLOR models are built upon the scaled YOLOV4 P6 architecture. First, a YOLOV4 P6 light version is constructed by changing the stem, the depth, and the output channels of the scaled YOLOV4 P6 model. Then, by changing the activation function on the light model to SILU, we get YOLOR P6. YOLOR W6 is built by increasing the output channels on P6, and YOLOR E6 further scales the channels in W6. It also uses the CSP convolution downsampling module. Finally, the YOLOR D6 is a collective model of all the above changes with increased depth backbone stages. Moreover, the implicit knowledge is modeled using trainable vectors. The first module helps with the kernel space misalignment problem. It is combined with explicit knowledge using the addition operator. The second module is for prediction refinement and is combined using the multiplication operator. On the COCO Dev test set, the YOLOR P6 variant achieves an average precision score of 54.1%, while the largest model, D6, achieves a spectacular 57.3%. YOLOR also provides two additional lightweight variants trained on 640 image size and are designed for resource-constrained environments with flops 18 times smaller than P6. Both the lightweight models are similar in architecture except for the stem. One uses discrete wavelet transform, and the other uses spatial-to-depth reorganization of pixels. Now let's head to some visual comparison. The big variants, trained on 1280 image size, often provide results that are visually similar, but there are fluctuations with small objects. To make the point more clear, here's a side-by-side comparison between the largest and the smallest YOLOR model. Next, we compare low-height drone footage video among the best models of YOLOR and YOLOV7. As you can see, the warehouse is detected as truck in the YOLOV7 result, but the amount of increase in speed is so large that the small decrease in accuracy is tolerable. And in high-altitude drone footage of an intersection, the best pre-trained models of both perform similarly. The parked cars were detected as cell phones, meanwhile the cars on the road were detected correctly. So, that's all about YOLOR. If you like this video, why don't you check out the YOLOV7 paper explanation video, or check out our other videos in the YOLO Masterclass playlist. Do comment what you like to see next, and don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Until next time.